Hello and welcome to Talk of Our Towns. We're here with State Senator Patty Ritchie. Senator Ritchie represents the 48th Senate District in Oswego, Jefferson, and St. Lawrence counties. Today we're also joined by Major General Mark Milley. And General Milley is the commanding general of the 10th Mountain Division and Fort Drum in the North Country. General, welcome. Senator Ritchie, welcome.
Thank you. Thanks, Chris.
We're here today talking about 10th Mountain Division Day and Fort Drum Day at the state capitol. It was a very large celebration we had today, and we'll open it right up with Senator Ritchie, and we'll ask you, maybe you could just explain to us what happened today at the capitol.
It really was an honor and a privilege today to have the commanding general and some of the representatives from the 10th Mountain Division here in Albany, and I think it showcased how important the 10th Mountain Division is to New York State and the nation at large. And also, you know, there are many comments from my colleagues that they didn't realize all the significance of the post and the 10th Mountain Division. So I think it was a great day to showcase all their accomplishments and what the 10th Mountain Division really stands for.
There was quite a lot of activity around the Capitol today. We saw a flyover of a Black Hawk helicopter to start the day with the arrival of General Milley. General Milley joined us in the Senate chamber today, and we'll ask you to talk about that for a little bit. But we've also had, we were treated to a lot of exhibits. Senator Ritchie, you mentioned that a lot of people don't really know a lot about what Fort Drum does and what Fort Drum is. So we had the opportunity to see that firsthand today as we were visited by a few dozen troops who came here to see us today.
It was great to actually get a chance to talk to the men and women from the 10th Mountain Division, hear some of their stories. And I think the same with many of my colleagues after they heard Major General Milley speaking today on all the accomplishments of the 10th Mountain Division. I think it really brought to light everything that they do for New York State and for the nation.
General Milley, can you tell us about the 10th Mountain Division? What is your, what's your mission? What's your role? And tell us about Fort Drum.
Well, the 10th Mountain's basic role for the nation, for the president's use, is to be a rapidly deployable light infantry division to put a lot of infantry capability out to a world's crisis spot on very, very short notice, 48, 96 hours notice. We can start moving forces at the president's order. And we do that in order to either prevent a crisis from breaking or to shape the outcome of a crisis or, in fact, if it involves combat operations, to fight and win. So the 10th is a very unique division in that it can move faster than any other division in the Army, and there's a significant amount of combat power that comes with it. So the speed and the rapid deployment is what is key at the national level for the 10th Mountain. 10th was formed back in World War II. It was formed as a light infantry dismounted division that specialized in mountain and winter warfare. A lot of the original members were professional skiers, college skiers, mountain climbers, those kind of guys. And then the division was deactivated after fighting in the northern Apennines Mountains in the Po Valley against the Nazi Gustav line in the early part of 1945, from January to the end of the war. Shortly after the war, the division was deactivated and then reactivated again at Fort Drum as a light infantry division in 1985. And since that time, the division's been deployed all over the world to all the hotspots, whether it's Haiti, Somalia, the Balkans, the Sinai Peninsula for peacekeeping, or whether it's earthquakes and other natural disasters. But for the last 10 years, we have gone consistently to Iraq and Afghanistan. So we've played an important role in all of the major events of U.S. foreign policy in the last 10 to 20 years.
You yourself spent some time overseas with the 10th Mountain Division since this is your second tour?
Third tour
with the division, and you've been commanding general since November of last year.
I have, yeah.
Afghanistan, Iraq?
I've deployed to both. Mm-hmm. Most of us in the division have deployed to both Iraq and Afghanistan. I'm not particularly unique. I've got several combat tours. The average combat tour of a non-commissioned officer of a sergeant in the 10th Mountain Division is four combat tours. We had, as Senator Ritchie said, we had several soldiers down here today. We brought about almost 70 or so for a variety of static displays, etc. And amongst those soldiers that were recognized in the Senate today, we had 15 soldiers, and among them represented, roughly speaking, about 12 cumulative years of combat operations in those just 15 soldiers. Several Purple Hearts, several awards for valor. So lots of combat. I personally have fought, but that is, again, not unique to the 10th. Almost everybody in the 10th has fought in both Afghanistan and Iraq.
You spoke a little bit on the floor of the Senate today about the tremendous growth that we've witnessed at Fort Drum. 1985 was when the 10th Mountain Division was returned to Fort Drum. Mm-hmm. We've seen growth, the number of battalions has increased, and the numbers that you were using today on the floor?
Well, right now we've got 20,000 soldiers and about another 20,000 family members and about 4,000 or 5,000 Department of the Army civilians. So all told, we have a population at Drum of, roughly speaking, between 40 and 45,000 folks affiliated, either soldiers, family members, or Department of the Army civilians. So that's a significant growth over where Fort Drum started in 1985. At that time, we had two infantry brigades, and today we have three. But in addition to that, we have nine total brigades, and you can think of a brigade of infantry of round figure about 4,000 or so folks. So we've grown at least by a third since Fort Drum was first put up there in 1985. And Fort Drum was designed to grow, and we anticipate a bright future.
Senator Ritchie, you saw the looks on the faces of the members, the other senators today. I think a lot of them were quite surprised, in fact, to see so many young men dressed very appropriately and looking very professional, reaching out to them and speaking to them about their experiences, and many of them had some tremendous experiences. What do you think was the reaction among the other senators today?
I think my colleagues, I think, were very surprised. I think they're very impressed. The Major General gave a pretty commanding speech at the chamber today, and I think everybody was very impressed. We also had a Gold Star mother with us, and I think that touched a lot of people's hearts in the chamber also.
It's worth noting today, you mentioned the Gold Star mother, Mrs. Esposito, who was with us today in the chamber. Yesterday, we celebrated Veterans Hall of Fame Day here in Albany, another Senate tradition where I think we try to recognize Military History Month, or Military Appreciation Month, excuse me, and talk about some of the contributions that our fighting men and women make, both to our national defense and also to the state.
Well, we were fortunate to be able to honor Colonel Plummer, who has a connection to Fort Drum, somebody who is very deserving, and somebody who I've heard from many of the individuals who came down today who were happy that he was the honoree for our district.
Do you think you made an impression here today, General? It's your first time in Albany, first time in the Capitol. Did you sense anything from the other senators?
I did. I sensed quite a bit of positive energy from the senators. Had a good session with the governor, and I think rightly so. All of the representatives are justly proud of New York's own, New York's 10th Division. And it's a big, huge statement that they voted and the governor signed in today, 23 May 2012, as 10th Mountain Division Day in the great state of New York. And, you know, when the terrorists attacked our country on 9/11 and they murdered the citizens of our nation, most of those murdered were in New York. And it was the 10th Mountain Division that was the first conventional force to go into Afghanistan. And we still have soldiers from the 10th there. So we think it's more than fitting, and we are proud to say we're New York's own. So I think there was a lot of positive energy, and it was good. It was a good day.
Of your 20,000 troops that you have right now at Fort Drum, and virtually everyone is back home now, with the exception of 1,000?
We've got about 1,000 soldiers from our sustainment brigade doing logistics functions in Regional Command East under Colonel Kurt Ryan. Mm-hmm. Everyone else right now is back home. So almost 19,000 or round figure or so are back at Drum, going through cycles of training, and because our basic function is readiness. Armies either are fighting in a war or you're preparing to fight a war. That's what armies do. So we're back at Drum, and we're training and preparing and maintaining and building our readiness.
3,000 of your troops at Fort Drum consider themselves New Yorkers. Maybe you all consider yourselves New Yorkers.
We do. We all do. I'm from Boston. I went to school in New Jersey, but my heart and soul's in New York. So we're all New Yorkers. We're rooting for the Rangers, and we love the Yankees.
That's great to hear. Good news.
Well, I think many of the soldiers have been important parts of the community, and that's something that I've heard may not take place in other areas, but we certainly appreciate having the post in the 48th and appreciate the soldiers being part of our community along with their families.
Well, the bond in Northern New York, I've been in 8th Division. The bond in Northern New York is unlike any I've seen elsewhere. We in many of our divisions, we have very good relations with the local surrounding communities, and it's important for our Army as a whole to maintain those linkages. But there's a very, very special bond in Northern New York, in large part due to the efforts of Senator Ritchie, she mentioned Mike Plummer. Mike Plummer was critical. He was the first chief of staff of the 10th Mountain Division. And the way the post was designed, the way the services were designed, was to make a symbiotic relationship between the Tri-County area and Fort Drum, and that's exactly what has happened. Our children are educated in the school systems, are sick, are nursed in the local hospitals and the medical care systems, and two-thirds of the 20,000 folks live in the local housing areas, and we all shop at the local stores. So there's an intricate and close and very positive relationship between Fort Drum and the surrounding communities. It's a great place to serve.
It's a fantastic place to live. The North Country, we all know, we call it home, and we really enjoy being there as well. And hopefully the troops, now that they're back home, can take some time to enjoy more of the many things that are out in the community for them to enjoy.
They will.
It's very important that myself, that I do everything to help showcase and help promote the post and all the wonderful things that you do and how important you are to the state and to the country at large.
Well, thanks. And we really do feel connected. You know, the United States Army, 14 June, our birthday's coming up, 14 June 1775. And from the very first day, the United States Army was the people's army. And it was fighting for the people, and it represents the people, and it was made up from the people. That continuous tradition has never ended. And we think it's very, very important that our Army stay connected, the People's Army stay connected to its people. And we do that in America through our elected representatives and through personal contact and representation through our people, et cetera. So that bond of the people and the People's Army is very, very solid in Northern New York. And we thank New York for being the state in which we live and work and train. And we thank the world of New York. And it's a wonderful state, and it's been very, very supportive of us.
Fantastic. The 10th Mountain Division, how does one become a member of the 10th Mountain Division? Is it something that you request? Is it something that you're assigned by your central command?
Well, ultimately, we're all federal soldiers. Ultimately, we all get orders and we get assigned. But yes, soldiers do have some measure of selection. Mm-hmm. So when a soldier graduates basic training AIT, they can request certain posts or locations. When you enlist, you can do it as part of an enlistment contract. As officers graduate either the basic or their career courses, they can request certain assignments. So there are ways in which you can request it. At the end of the day, the needs of the Army come first, but we do try to do our best to help soldiers get to where they want. And when they can reenlist under contract to stay at Fort Drum. We have 100% reenlistment rate. We have very strong. Despite the sacrifice, despite 10 consecutive years of war, we've lost 295 soldiers from the 10th Mountain Division in the last 10 years fighting for our nation. Despite all that agony and sacrifice and blood, our reenlistment strength, bonding, cohesion, resiliency is as strong as it's ever been. And it's demonstrated in things like reenlistment for the 10th Mountain to stay with the division, and it's very, very high.
That certainly speaks to the commitment of the soldiers that you have there.
Does.
Well, we'll be. This was another episode of Talk of Our Towns with Senator Patty Ritchie, and we are just about out of time. So I want to thank our guests today, Senator Patty Ritchie, Major General Mark Milley from the 10th Mountain Division in Fort Drum.
Thank you. Thanks for coming,
Senator. Thank you. Thanks for all you do.
Thank you.